Now, an aristocratic British family is members of an aristocratic British family are due to travel to Grenada to publicly apologise for the ownership of more than 1,000 enslaved Africans in the 19th century. The Trevelyan family will also pay reparations to the people of Grenada, where it owned 6 sugar plantations. One member is my colleague Laura Trevelyan. She is BBC presenter in Washington and in New York, and she's been speaking to reporter Azadeh Moshiri in a personal capacity.
He can't even say the word. Wow.
Hi, I'm Dexter, and welcome to my channel, where I discuss all things Caribbean history and genealogy. Thank you so much for the really insightful comments on my previous videos, and for the 400 of you that have subscribed to my channel. If you haven't already subscribed yourself, please hit that subscribe button right now. In this video, I will be discussing reparations. In 1835, the Trevelyan family were paid compensation for the loss of more than 1,000 enslaved persons. The British government, they paid this money to enslavers who owned the rights to the enslaved persons' labor. And this, termed as a compromise to make peace with the abolitionists, was the largest debt that had ever been taken out by the British government, to the tune of £20 million. The terms of this were that the individuals who had been granted their freedom, they were not really quite free just yet. Their status had been changed from chattel to being a person again. Those individuals, they not only received no compensation, but they were required to become apprentices to the same people that enslaved them, that got compensation for enslaving them, and were required to work for an additional 4 years as apprentices. Fast forward into the 20th century, and the family members, they had no idea about this. During some research, one of the cousins within the family went onto the UCL Legacies of British Slavery database and did a search for their surname, and they were completely dismayed by the fact that some of their ancestors were in that list. There were 33 different claims, and it was just the list of people. It was more than 1,000. And what they had been told was that their family, they were highly ranking civil servants who were liberal leaning. They had no idea. I have to admit, when I first saw the documentary last year of Laura Trevelyan, one of the descendants, visiting Grenada and going to a primary school and asking pupils about their thoughts on the slave trade and the system of slavery, and receiving some really insightful responses. And she was visibly moved by interacting with some of these young people who, you know, very well would have been descendants of people that her ancestors very likely would have enslaved, led her to start questioning exactly what her role could be, and, you know, coming to terms with that history. She spoke with a gentleman who was a confirmed descendant of someone that had been enslaved by her family. I could see that she really recognized that her family, her ancestors, they accumulated significant wealth, and this was at the expense of the life chances of the people that she had been speaking with, and that she was relatively rich because they had been made poor. The cynic in me thought, okay, well, you know, she's just gone there to, you know, satisfy herself that, you know, everything is okay, and that she's a good person for going there and talking with the people, and then that would be it. And maybe she'd write a book about it and would donate, you know, 1% of the the earnings from the book to a charity. But I was wrong. The family, they've established a £100,000 fund, and they will travel to Grenada as a family to formally apologize to the people of Grenada for the atrocities committed by their ancestors. This is to actually go about looking at solutions and to try to improve the capacity of the people living on the island, which I think is a very commendable thing. Now, you may ask, it's been nearly 200 years later, why are they doing this now? Well, my short answer to this, better late than never. But I started thinking a bit further. What exactly is a reparation? A reparation is a payment in order to compensate for harm or injury that had been inflicted upon another person, community, or a nation. Reparations are meant to repair the harm inflicted upon those individuals. And this payment can be in cash or in kind. Reparations can also be demanded of nations that have been defeated in war as compensation for the damage that had been done. A really well-documented example of this is compensation demanded of Germany after the Second World War. This was predominantly paid in the demolition of the machinery that had allowed them to actually wage war. So artillery and anything that was useful, they had to hand that over to the Allied forces. They had to go through all of their economic production infrastructure, and they had to dismantle and hand that over. They also had to part with any investments overseas in any securities, as well as in gold and silver. And they also had to then give the labor of the German people for a period of time in order to then compensate for the war. There was cash payment, however, as well, specifically to the victims of the Holocaust, who have been to date paid over 60 billion euros. Now, does the act of paying reparations to Grenada by the Trevelyan family, does that set an example, and does it actually put pressure on anyone else to take greater action? In the letter that is being signed by the Trevelyans, they have a demand for others who are in a similar position to consider what they gained from the system of slavery, and to think very carefully about how they may not only apologize as well, but if they may be able to pay some form of reparation compensation. There are a number of names that come to mind. Benedict Cumberbatch, I'm looking at you. As well as Richard Drax and many other names that we, as West Indians, we will know the names, but is asking the Crown to then make a formal apology and pay reparations. Is that going to change very much? Possibly. I think over the past 80 years or so in Britain, with the decline of the British Empire, there is a concern that, well, all of the power and all of the money is gone, and, you know, what is it that Britain can actually do in a realistic, achievable way to make right those wrongs? I think that the International Centre for Transitional Justice said it very well, in that reparations are meant to repair the harms of what has been done in the past, but it also is meant to be an act of acknowledgement of the wrongs of the past, as well as how those wrongs are currently being felt through the economic system and the systematic criminalization of people racialized as black. Understanding the intricacies of reparations and how they actually are most effective, or you know, the argument for forgetting them and then just trying to redistribute all wealth across all people. This is a really big political and economic and philosophical conundrum in order to unpick all of this, and it's way outside the scope of this video. But thanks for watching all the way to the end. And if you like this video, then please hit the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. It really helps others to find my content. If you'd like to get more of this type of content from me, please leave some comments down below and I will see how I get on with that. So until then, see you on the next one.